Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So, today I am doing a review. Not a review because I use both of them. I'm just going to show you the difference between the Kara, it's like a Kara dip brow, and the Anastasia dip brow. So they're two different brands, and I've said that to me they work the same, and it is very early. I'm getting ready for work, so I wanted to show you guys, make a quick little video with that, and then if you stay tuned, my next video, you'll see that is pulled up. My light just went out. I don't know what's wrong with this light. I spent money on this light, but well, you can still see me a little bit when we turn it off. Okay, so I wanted to do a, so it's like a get ready with me, whatever, but I'm doing the Kara and then I'm doing the Anastasia. I'm going to show you the difference on each brow on how they apply, and if you can tell the difference, because one is $18 and one is $8, so yeah. So I got my coffee this morning. I'm getting ready for work. It is comfy week, so I am in a sweatsuit. Just gonna, so my makeup's not going to be like glamorous. I'm just gonna go ahead and do something simple. Oh, in my next video, if you see, I will also post a how to apply your eyeliner and also apply eyelashes. This is the easiest way, even with nails, because the hardest thing for me is when I have nails and I'm applying eyelashes. But I'm gonna do a simple look, just like something quick. So if you want to keep on watching, go ahead. Okay, so for this brow, I'm going to be using the Kara, and for this brow, I'm going to be using the Anastasia. For my brows, what I normally do before I apply any of the dip brows, I combo it with a pencil. So this is an actual travel size kit. This is the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil. I'm in love with this, and I got it free with the purchase, so I was really, really happy because this thing was like $23 retail, and it's like the same size, but it's a little bit bigger because you have a spoolie at the end. So I'm in the shade number 5. Sometimes I'll pull off a number 6, but I just underline the, I wasn't paying attention. So I underline the brow section. And you're always going to hear me say it's like coloring. Like you know how when you were little, you color, you outline the lines, and then you color in? That's the way I look at it. So, I love Precise Brow. And you can even use this thing as just like your main brow. You don't have to use a dip brow. Me, personally, I do both, because I like to have my hair stick down, and I'm like, I draw on my eyebrows, you know, I'd rather just go all the way, but that's just me, that's my personal, don't mind my fan in the background, because I sweat, I don't know why. Oh, and today was my first day at the gym, so I've been up since about 4:30. So I've been up since 4:30. I went to the gym, came back, took out my ground turkey, took out my eggs, a little bit of cheese, my zucchinis. So I'm going to have a healthy day today. I got some watered down lemonade. So lemonade's really sweet, and I love, I've been on lemonade, tea, and water. Have not drunk soda. And those who know me, I am like literally 5 to 6 cans a day. 5 to 6 cans. Not the small cans. No, not the small cans, the big cans. I could finish a whole 24 pack in 2 weeks. Yeah, it's that bad. So anyways, back to my brows. So I outline the brow. So how, and you want to go by based off of whatever your shape is on your brow, or if you don't have any brows at all, it's like kind of the best, because you can shape your brows however you want. You can do them square, you can do them sharp, you can do them round, you can do them natural, you can do a whole bunch of stuff. So on this side, I'm going to use the Cara. This is a Cara brand. It's not like a big, I mean, it's a big brand, but it's not like a out there brand like, ooh, like something expensive like this. It's more of like a cheaper, affordable brand. Cara, you cannot find it in, I don't believe you can find it on in drugstores. You would have to look on your website. If you're an online shopper, perfect for you. If you're not an online shopper, I will definitely try to look into something that's kind of similar of a dip brow. I don't have any ideas of any drugstore ones that are as thick and like texturized as this one. I bought this one at a beauty convention. So I outlined my top brow before I color it in. I bought this at a beauty convention thing that it's like a beauty, they had a whole beauty hole thing of like different brands, not like they had Beauty Creations, they had Cara, they had just a whole bunch of other, like, I don't want to say off-brands because they're not off-brands, they're just their own brand. They're just more affordable brands. So, so I bought it there, and I bought a whole bunch of stuff there. Actually, I bought these masks, these facial masks. Sorry, I'm, like, crashing because I'm tired. I bought these facial masks there, too, and I have yet to try them, so I'm going to try them online with you guys. So anyways, I'm not trying to make this video long, but I keep on talking. Because you know I haven't got my friends. So this is the Cara, as you can see. I fluff up the front just so it don't look as boxy. I try to do the fadeaway, but I really can't. I don't know why. I don't know why I can't do it. I try. I don't know. So this is one brow. So next, I'm gonna wipe my brow brush, and the brow brush that I used, and it was like the best investment ever. Because they're kind of expensive, but if you don't like, they're not, I don't think they're a cruelty-free product, brand. It's not, I don't think so. Correct me if I'm wrong, but from what I heard, I don't think they are. So, you can find another brush. Morphe is like the best second brand, but this is my dip brow. Like, I use this on a daily. And I use this brush by MAC. It's 266, I think, or 286, the number rubbed off. But this brow pencil is really, really good. It was kind of expensive. The brows are expensive just because of the hairs on the brows. I think they're real. But I heard they're not cruelty-free, or they're not animal. I don't know what it is, but it's something like that. So a lot of people don't like to use their brushes. Or they test on animals. Not animals. They don't be cruel to animals. I think they test on animals. That's what it was. So some people like will not even like mess with it if they got anything to do with animals. And I think that they do test on animals. Correct me if I'm wrong. So some people don't like to buy their product as far as like their brushes and stuff. It's kind of like it's not like an Ugg thing. I'm not even going to compare that because I watched a video about Uggs. If you haven't watched a video about Uggs, watch a video about Uggs on how they make them. I told myself I wasn't going to buy a pair, but I went to Ross in LA and I found a pair for $50 in my size because I wear a kid size. So I ended up buying them because they were cute and they were the ones that I wanted. But I was kind of like mind tortured when I watched it the first time. So I'm going to go back in with the Cara thing, and I'm just going to carve this one out, because your brows, I try to make them the same, but honestly, your brows are never going to be twins. They're going to be sisters. And as long as they sisters, cool. Yeah, I don't think you're ever going to get your brows to be twins. So, not make one again. This brow's always more archier than this brow, and I don't know why. One brow just comes out perfect, and the other one just don't be messing with you. Okay, so I don't know if you could see the difference. This is the first time I've ever did this, of using two different brow products. Using two different brow products on comparison of one of the other, but I honestly feel like they kind of look the same. There's not really big of a difference. But after I do that, what I do is I got this for free too. It's the Boing Concealer. Boing Concealer by Benefit. Or you can just get any concealer. This one is by, it's by Rimmel Perfection. And what I do is I just go like, just put some on my eyelids. And then I used to use the e.l.f. I'm going to use two different. So this is the e.l.f. I'm going to wipe it off because I use it to do a cut crease. So there's some color on there. So this is the e.l.f. Let me see what time it is. Oh, I need to hurry up. So this is the e.l.f. And then I'm going to use the new brush that I got by Morphe, so you can see the difference too. Because Morphe is a little bit expensive compared to, well, it's a little bit more out of pocket of money versus the e.l.f. This one is like $3. And the e.l.f. one, I mean the Morphe one is $7. So this is the Morphe, and this is the Morphe M32. And it looks just like that. See, like this. This one's a little bit more fluffier than this one. This is more like stiff and thin. This one's a little bit. This one's more thicker. And it does. I feel like it grabs more product too than the other one. I really like these brushes. These are really affordable brushes. Like if you don't want to get brushes that are like really expensive, but you really want good brushes, Morphe is a really good brand, and Beauty Creations and Be Bella is a really good brand. Products though, so. But these are really good brands. Like if you want to spend on good quality, but you don't want to spend heck of money like $20 on a brush at Sephora. Morphe is a good brand, and they have it at Ulta now, and you can order it online. But that is my brow tutorial, so I don't really see the difference. I don't know if you do. You can comment below, like the video. Don't forget to subscribe, and also follow me on Snapchat, and also my Instagram page is at BeautySoulChild_, and you can find my information for my Snapchat, and also link to my YouTube and other pictures that I have of different looks. Thanks, guys.